going on, YouTube? I'm back. We got a wedding gig log. First of 2020. Second party of the year. But it was a fun day. Beautiful day. Long day. It was from like 2 o'clock to 10 o'clock. 8 hours. So, yeah, real long day. They had their own house system, which I was able to plug into. I only brought my EVs, the 50s. I kept them on the main. And the rest of the house was all surround sound, so I didn't need... And they had another bass box somewhere off to the side. So it was awesome. Own lighting system. So we had ceremony, reception, and cocktail hour. And that's about it. So let's see how you like it. And this is what you have to look forward to during COVID-19. We had about quite a few guests not show up due to that. I think we had maybe 100 people, so it's about 150. So, let's see how it goes. Wedding number one of the season. Running the J Mix RC. RCF J Mix. With the regular hardline mic. Got this idea from Nick Spinelli. I have a wireless setup, but just doesn't sound as good as the hardline. So, about 110 to 140 people, not sure. Real humid day. And that's about it. So, quick setup, battery powered. See you later. Peace.
Thank you for serving, guys. You're doing an amazing job.
John Young's son. So far, so good. It's a QR code, you send it out. And that's it.
What's up? The new app, DJ Request. John Young's son, I think, made this app. $9 or $10 a month. You get your request through a QR code. Boom. Let's give you 1 second. We're working here. Our QR code's right there. Boom. They get it. They get the request, and I either put a favorite, I put it played, I could even block the person if the person puts request and request the same song, and it would tell me how many times that song has been requested. Somebody's requested multiple times.
Oh, that's actually very handy.
Yep.
Hello. Hi. So, for those of you who don't know me, I am the bride's sister. So I'm gonna make this real short, pretty to the point. So I have, you know, been a large part of my life for 22 years now. When we grew up, for those of you who don't know us, I was not exactly the biggest fan of her. I didn't really want a sister. but, you know, as we grew up together and, you know, I kind of helped raise her a little bit, we became very, very close, and she is definitely my best friend in the world. So I am very proud of you. I'm very excited for you. And I know you guys are going to be really happy together, and you're going to be great friends. I love you.
Alrighty, so for all of you who don't know me, I'm Ryan, Mark's little brother. So to be asked today by Mark to be his best man is an honor for me, and it's also a very honorable thing for him to do because he's finally admitting that I'm the best. That's a big moment in our lives, he finally realized that. So I met Mark about 20 years ago. He acted as my protector from Jeff, right here. You guys all know him if you're part of the family, it's a pain in the butt. He was also my teammates and starting fights and trouble in the house. But with trouble comes getting out of it. And now I'm going to tell a little story. Some of you guys might know this if you're close to the family, you probably won't. So growing up, Mark loved rope. Everybody in the family knew this, so if he went on vacation with us, he knew that he had rope on him at all times. Or in his car when he turned 16, it was everywhere throughout the house. Anybody knows about Mark's outlet, you know, it was named after him because of the rope, Loki. So he was the monkey in the family due to the rope. He was always having it around him. But he's also always climbing trees. And I know you guys think we're calling him monkey for a different reason because of these, but it's just because of the rope and the trees. So when me and Mark were younger, we decided we want to make a zip line in the backyard. This is where we actually got a real one. So Mark had a nice climbing harness for it was either Christmas or his birthday. And we decided to hang a big rope from a tree about 20 feet up in the air from tree to tree. And Mark and me didn't realize that nylon rope stretched. So he jumped out of the tree with the harness all clipped in and sagged right to the middle, just far enough where his toes couldn't touch the ground, and he was sitting there with the biggest wedge of his lifetime. So, my job, obviously, was the guy who's sitting there laughing at him, watching him hang there, with his legs going numb because of the harness, was to get him out of the trouble. So I had to pick him up and unclip the harness, and it was a pain in the butt. I think you remember that, because we were both probably 10 or 12, and it's a pain in the butt to lift a 100-pound kid above your head. So, after we got him unstuck, I realized that I was going to have to be the person with Lance. 23, to be able to be the guy to get him out of the sticky situations. And now, Lauren, I haven't been hitting the weights because you might have to lift him up soon because now you're his trouble solver, his problem solver. So, everybody can raise a glass. I'd like to wish a happy and healthy life to the new bride and groom. Good luck in Kansas. Woo!
Oh, first move.
Bye-bye.